Welcome back to Combat Tech. I'm Steven, and I want you to imagine the year 2029. A U.S. carrier strike group slices toward a Pacific flashpoint, but the sleek escort that was supposed to be guarding its flanks is still in dry dock, only 10% complete. In a fight measured in minutes, can America afford a half-built Guardian? Missiles are faster, seas more lethal, and the U.S. Navy's answer was meant to be a game-changer. The Constellation-Class Guided Missile Frigate, stripped from Europe's combat-proven FREMM design, tweaked and rushed into service. The promise? A lethal, affordable hunter stalking enemy submarines and missiles at the edge of the fight. Quick refresher, if you missed our original deep dive on Constellation's birth and bold ambitions, check out the link in this video. So, 5 years after the contract award, that promise is caught in a storm of redesigns, cost spikes, and political backlash. What went wrong? Why does it matter? And, most urgently, how do we get this warship back to sea before the shooting starts? Tonight, we dive into the steel, software, and high-stakes politics of the Navy's most beleaguered warship. Buckle up. After the literal combat ship debacle, the Navy vowed never again. The 2017 FFGX competition required an existing design with minimal changes. Italy's sturdy FREMM answered the call. In April 2020, Fincantieri's Marinette Marine Yard in Wisconsin landed an $800 million detailed design contract, vowing 85% commonality with its European twin and first delivery by 2026. The plan seemed bulletproof. Start with a hull that already steam combat patrols, bolt on US missiles and Aegis code, crank out ships at $1 billion apiece, and fill the yawning gap below Arleigh Burke destroyers. Reality had other ideas. Growing pains. Lengthen 24 feet for bigger diesel generators and future power-hungry lasers. Displacement up to approximately 7,400 tons. Blurring the line between small surface combatant and pocket destroyer. Survivability rules added ballistic hull protection, more watertight bulkheads, and new firefighting zones. Combat system overhaul. The Italian radar and combat data systems were ripped out. The AN Spy 6A ESA radar, same family as the Flight 3 Burke's I. Aegis Baseline 10 Brain, integrating with Navy Integrated Fire Control, Counter Air, 32, Cell Strike Length, Mark 41, VLS for SM2, Tomahawk, ASROC, and, one day, hypersonics. 16 Naval Strike Missiles in canisters for knife fight sea skirmishes, a 57mm Mark 110 rapid-fire gun, and RAM Block 3-point defense. Each upgrade sounded sensible, until engineers discovered that only 15% of the original FREMM architecture survived the surgery. Construction began August 2022, before the drawings were frozen. Design completeness today, still awaiting functional design approval, now projected for late summer 2025. Build progress, approximately 10% on the lead ship after nearly 3 years.
During our meeting, we discussed, if you recall, at length, contracting delays, skilled personnel shortages, and overspending related to shipbuilding.
Delivery date slipped from 2026 to 2029, a 36-month delay baked into the books. Unit cost ballooned to $1.4 billion, 40% over the early promise, with analysts warning of $1.6 billion if weight creeps again. Can a frigate that costs as much as an aircraft carrier's air wing still be called affordable?
And as you know, the Constellation-class frigate contract was awarded in 2020 during President Trump's first term. Unfortunately, it's experiencing delays with an expected delivery date of 2029 instead of 2026. And now, while some of this delay was certainly caused by industry, unfortunately, a good portion of that blame can be squarely put on the Navy.
America's shipyards are swimming against a riptide of labor shortages. Fincantieri poured $300 million into Marinette's new covered hulls, convinced it can crank out two frigates a year, if only it can hire enough welders, shipfitters, and electricians. On the 11th of April 2025, the Navy quietly fired a rescue flare. Serco Incorporated landed a $96 million recompete contract, 1 year base plus 4 option years, to keep providing the systems engineering muscle behind Constellation's planning, design, construction, delivery, and testing. We understand the critical importance of these new platforms, pledged Serco CEO Tom Watson, promising advanced maritime systems engineering to sharpen the frigate's mission readiness. Serco's cadre of naval architects and test engineers can't weld bulkheads, but they can close the gaping paperwork gulf delaying production. Their task force will burn down the design backlog. More engineers on the Navy Fincantieri review loop should hasten that long-awaited functional design freeze, letting the yard cut steel with confidence. Streamline system integration. Serco's specialty is marrying government combat system requirements to commercial shipyard realities, exactly the friction point that ballooned the commonality gap from 15% to 85%. Compress post-shakedown work. Early involvement in test procedure drafting could shave months off acceptance trials once the first hull finally floats. Will $96 million erase the workforce deficit or the 36-month slip? No. But by outsourcing the knowledge work choke points, the Navy buys time to train welders, certify suppliers, and let those gleaming hulls in Wisconsin hit their promised cadence. Think of it as adding a turbocharger to an engine that still needs fresh oil. Necessary, not sufficient, but a genuine boost. Distributed maritime operations demand many small, lethal nodes, not a handful of golden egg destroyers. In contested littorals, Arleigh Burkes are overkill targets. Unmanned corvettes lack staying power. The Constellation, on paper, slots perfectly between. Its towed CAPT-S-4 sonar promises blue water ASW reach beyond anything left after the Perry-class retirements. With SM-2 and NSM, it can shield logistics convoys or punch holes in blockade lines, if it ever floats. If a future war hinges on quantity plus quality, do we risk defeat before the keel is even complete? 1. Freeze the design now. Lock specs, accept compromises, and drive hot production lines. 2. Second shipyard. Split the batch, inject competition, but risk duplicated teething pains. 3. Spiral block upgrades. Deliver a Flight Zero hull with baseline AAW-ASW. Bolt on lasers and extra VLS later. 4. Stand-in alternatives. Upgun the Arleigh Burke. Flight 3, repeat buys, or accelerate unmanned surface combatants. The Joint Strike Frigate concept whispered in the Pentagon's halls. Each path carries peril, but indecision guarantees that the Navy's fleet target of 381 ships by 2040 remains a paper exercise. Steel is forgiving. Schedules are not. The Constellation's troubles are a microcosm of a shipbuilding base fighting for survival against rising adversaries and its own bureaucracy. If the Navy can stabilize the design, flood yards with skilled labor, and resist the lure of perfect over good enough, these frigates could still prowl the world's choke points, silent, lethal, and networked into an American fleet built for the 21st century storm. Fail, and the United States may find itself sailing into the next war with yesterday's ships and tomorrow's regrets. So, will the Navy right the course, or will Constellation become another cautionary tale etched into rusting hull plates beside the literal combat ship? Sound off below. Do we double down or pivot? Subscribe to Combat Tech for frontline analysis of every breakthrough and every breakdown, shaping the future of war at sea. Because in this age of hypersonic salvos and invisible hunters, knowledge is the first layer of armor.